In 1959, the board game Diplomacy was introduced to the world. A lot has changed since then, but Diplomacy is still thriving today. Its mechanics are elegant and streamlined, and we see its impact in modern and classic board games. Today, we look at 10 other games you might enjoy playing if you love Diplomacy, here on Legendary Tactics. What is it you love about Diplomacy? Is it the negotiation? The deal-making? The deal-breaking? Do you love the tactical gameplay, the overarching strategy, or is it the social interaction that keeps you coming back? Whatever it is, this video is designed to help you find other games that you might like too, that share similar mechanics. Let's get to it. Number 10. If you love playing historical games that simulate and recreate particular periods in human history, then you might also enjoy The Republic of Rome. It's a game of agreements, deal-making, and political intrigue. In the rulebook, the designer says this game is for those who find diplomacy too tame. The game spans 250 years of Roman history, it simulates the politics of a Roman Senate, and at times players are forced to cooperate to overcome wars, famine, unrest, and bankruptcy. Like Diplomacy, you need friends in the game, and they can sometimes be very hard won. Number 9. If you haven't heard of the coin series from GMT, you might want to check it out. It uses asymmetrical guerrilla warfare in historical and contemporary conflicts. It's also driven heavily by negotiation. The game Fire in the Lake is a non-traditional war game where alliances are fluid, temporary, transient, but necessary. This conflict in South Vietnam was created by Mark Herman and Volko Runke, two incredible game designers, and if you love negotiations and diplomacy, this game will likely appeal to you. One caveat, though, is that this game is very complex and it will take a long time to learn. Number 8. Perhaps the features that make Diplomacy so unique is the freedom to form and break alliances at will. Nothing is binding. Another incredible game, and also one of my favorites, is Cosmic Encounter. Negotiations happen in real time as each player begs for help to either secure their home planet or to destroy their opponents. Deals are brokered, alliances are formed and then shattered as quickly as they began. It's rife with interaction and it plays well with either heavy or light gamers. Number 7. If you love games with player elimination, you might also like the game Machiavelli. It also features simultaneous action selection and negotiation. This is another classic game from 1977 that focuses on the ever-shifting balance of power in Renaissance Italy. This game shares the same basic rules from its predecessor, Diplomacy, such as the turn order of spring, summer, and fall sequences. As the name suggests, it can be ruthlessly driven by area and military control. The end goal is to control 15 provinces, so almost as good as Diplomacy's 18. Number 6. This is all about time-tested treachery. If you think about games that are most likely to make your friends hate you, the immediate candidates are Shadows over Camelot, Battlestar Galactica, and Betrayal at the House on the Hill. I don't actually think that Diplomacy players will naturally love these games though, just because they share the traitor mechanic. In each of them, one player turns bad partway through the game, and knowing that this will happen changes everything. What makes Diplomacy so riveting is that you never know who will turn on you and when. In Betrayal at the House on the Hill, for example, it's the game that determines the traitor. These games intentionally set out to pit one player against the rest, but there's another that also builds treachery in very intentionally. Dune, the board game, is not only a classic science fiction novel, but also a time-tested 40-year-old game, just like Diplomacy. It's a troops-on-the-map kind of game that emphasizes forming alliance. One key difference, though, is that Dune enforces alliance much more strictly than Diplomacy does with binding agreements. Built into the game system are treachery and traitor cards. So if you love stabbing your friends, this game builds it in naturally into the gameplay. It's certainly not as ruthless as Diplomacy, but I consider it a friendly, stabby game. If you like Dune, you might also like Rex, The Final Days of an Empire, which is set in the Twilight Imperium universe. Number 5. One of the biggest and most famous games on the market is Twilight Imperium 4th Edition. It features political cards that allow players to negotiate and put cards into play that have lasting effects in the game. You need to be able to use language to negotiate the most effective resolutions for your game. Negotiation is a keystone in this game, whether it's getting other players to back away from certain tiles or helping you tag team an opponent, you need to work the board and manage the other players in this game. By the way, if you love stabbing, then be sure to stab that subscribe button so you won't miss any of our other Diplomacy and board game content. Number 4. If we're looking for games like Diplomacy, we need to consider games about conquest and area control. Some runners-up in this spot are Risk, Axis and Allies, Imperial, and The King is Dead. But since this is a list of only 10, I can only choose one. And for this slot, it's Gearworld, the Borderlands. The designers of this game intentionally created a game that would play like Diplomacy for 2-4 players. It includes army building, attacking your opponents, area control, and collecting resources, rather than winning supply centers. Though games like Cosmic Encounter, Dune, and Rex are much better games and much more fun to play, this one is more like a first cousin to Diplomacy, and it shares a lot of similarities in the game mechanics. Number 3. Politics and negotiation come together beautifully in Rainer Knizia's game Quo Vadis. But another game that I love, Article 27, uses language, the power of persuasion, and social interaction to help you to victory, even more than in Quo Vadis. Thematically, Article 27 is really badly named, and it sounds really awful to play. But as a social game where deals are non-binding and interaction with your opponents is fundamental to the game, Diplomacy players are likely to thrive at the underhanded tactics that you sometimes need to strong-arm others to your way of seeing each omnibus bill through each turn. It really is quite a bit of fun. Number 2. Diplomacy is most infamous for its nasty backstabbery. Some honorable mentions in this position are Alcatraz, the Scapegoat. This was in 2011, where players have to work really hard to break out of prison, but ultimately they need to leave one player behind. It's brutal. Not surprisingly, the really nasty horse racing game is also horribly treacherous. You actually try to make other players' horses trip. But there's an even more evil game out there, and that's Intrigue from 1994. This is one of the meanest and nastiest negotiation games you'll ever play. You'll bribe the other players, but there's no obligation to follow through. It's a game purely based on nepotism and greed. The most evil player will win, and it can only be played by people who can handle some nasty play. The number one game that is most like Diplomacy, in my mind, is A Game of Thrones, the board game. Your ultimate goal is to expand your influence across a map of Westeros, to muscle out the other six houses, gain control of castles and strongholds, and negotiate your way to victory. Secret orders are revealed simultaneously. In addition to the basic orders in Diplomacy, you can also raid and gain power in this game. Of all the games on this list, this is the one that's most derivative of Diplomacy, but it's also a great game in its own right. The digital implementation is really good too. In the end, if you're trying to find a game that most closely matches Diplomacy and one that's really fun to play, this is your game. If you got value out of this video or you enjoyed finding out about other games that use Diplomacy mechanics, give us a like and check out our Diplomacy playlist with all kinds of great strategy, scholarship, and analysis. If you think I missed any board games here that remind you a lot of Diplomacy, or if there are just other board games that you love and you're a Diplomacy player, please share it in the comments. We'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks so much for your time.